1.7 Paramveer Chakra, our heroes. You may have heard about legendary heroes of the past and their extraordinary acts of bravery. But even today, many brave soldiers of our country sacrifice their own lives for our safety. Their brave deeds are honored by bestowing military decorations on them. Paramveer Chakra is India's highest military decoration. It is awarded for the most conspicuous bravery or some daring or preeminent act of valor or self-sacrifice, in the presence of the enemy, whether on land, at sea or in the air. The Paramveer Chakra is a very rare honor. So far, it has been awarded only 21 times. 14 of these awards were given posthumously. Indra's Vajra or Thunderbolt is supposed to be a matchless weapon. But what makes the weapon invincible is the supreme sacrifice of the sage Dadhichi. According to legend, thousands of years ago, a demon had stolen all the water in the world. Innocent people were suffering and dying without water. This demon could not be defeated by any ordinary weapon made of ordinary material like wood, metal, etc. Something extraordinary was required. It was learned that the sage Dadhichi was a noble person. He himself laid down his life and gave this own bone to help the people. Indravajra, Indra's weapon of thunderbolts, was fashioned from these bones and the demon was defeated. Just as the Indravajra derived power from sage Dadhichi's bones, the Indian military derives its strength and power from the sacrifice of the bravest of the brave, the Paramveer Chakra holders. The medal itself is very simple in appearance. It is made of bronze and is fitted with swivel mounting and has a plain purple ribbon. On the obverse, it has the Indian national emblem at the center, surrounded by four replicas of Indra's Vajra. On the reverse, the words Paramveer Chakra are engraved in Hindi and English, with two lotus flowers in between. The Paramveer Chakra medal was designed by Savitribai Kanolkar. She was a European lady who married Vikram Kanolkar, an Indian Army officer. Savitribai loved India and took Indian citizenship. She spoke Marathi, Sanskrit, Hindi fluently and had studied Indian arts and traditions in depth. The 21 bravest of the brave, Paramveer Major Somnath Sharma, Lance Nayak Karam Singh, 2nd Lieutenant Rama Raghoba Rane, Nayak Jadunath Singh, Company Havildar Major Peru, Captain Gurbachan Singh Salaria, Major Dhan Singh Thapa, Sabidar Joginder Singh, Major Shaitan Singh, Company Quarter Master Havildar Abdul Hamid, Lieutenant Colonel R. Deshir Bazorji Tharapur, Lance Nayak Albert Eka, 2 Lieutenant Arun Ketapal, Major Hoshiar Singh, Naib Sabidar Bana Singh, Major Ramaswamy Permeswaran, Lieutenant Manoj Kumar Pandey, Grenadier Yogendra Singh Yadav, Rifleman Sanjay Kumar, Captain Vikram Batra, Flying Office Nirmal Jeet Singh se kaun? Flying Office Nirmal Jeet Singh se kaun 10,877 F.P.P.V.C. Squadron number 18. The Flying Bullets. On the 14th of December 1971, Srinagar airfield was attacked by a wave of six enemy Sabre aircraft. Flying Office Nirmal Jeet Singh se kaun was on readiness duty at that time. He could not take off immediately because of clouds of dust raised by another aircraft. By the time the runways was clear, the enemy aircraft were overhead. They were flying low, firing and attacking the airfield with bombs. Even then, Flying Officer Sekon took off in his NAT fighter the moment he could. He began to combat the powerful Sabre jet aircraft of the enemy. He damaged two of them. His fight with the attacking aircraft now continued at treetop height. At last, the enemy aircraft fled from the scene of battle. The airfield and the town of Srinagar were saved. But alas! Flying Officer Sekon's aircraft, too, crashed and he was killed. Flying Officer Sekon displayed great flying skill and determination in the face of certain death. He showed unmatched heroism above and beyond the call of duty. Salute to the bravest of the brave, Flying Officer Nirmal Jeet Singh Sekon. Do read more on the internet at www.paramvirchakra.com about the gallant PVC awardees who laid down their lives in the service of the country. You will see that they belong to various communities and religions. Do find and read the inspiring accounts of how they faced the enemy without any regard for their fatal wounds and physical pain.